Toronto to Jasper, 121, room at 4. Okay.
Sure got it right.
There you go.
On pin, next one up.
Thank you.
Hello, where are you doing?
Red Lake Road.
Okay, next guy up, please.
See, the numbers are just on top of the ceiling there, 1, 2, 3. And you're in number 4.
How
cold
are we getting?
Okay,
fine.
Where am I going?
Yeah.
Pardon me?
Okay, next stop.
Okay.
Okay, next one up. Okay, this one, left to the left.
Hi.
Another starting of a good trip. Thank you.
Having a good time so far?
So far, so good. What are we in, 20 minutes?
Yeah,
right. Hi,
West side of Lake Simcoe.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome aboard. I just came to introduce myself. I'm Dion. I'm the activity coordinator, and I'll be with you all the way to Winnipeg. The whole crew's from Winnipeg, so you'll get a mediocre crew leaving Winnipeg, but, you know, them's the breaks. Can't get the best all the time. If you watch that whiteboard, just get out there.
What do you think, Mom?
Thank you. Right now we're waiting for our second spot to pull up for our guests that are in training here. We're expecting a couple.
Okay, for doors, right hand side.
Right,
it's caramels,
is it? It's the campbell. Am I right?
Yes.
I think so.
I'll get the box.
Thanks,
Aaron.
Appreciate it.
Possibility that there's a broken rail or
you know, really?
Rail.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Some chicken wings.
Yep. Work.
Yes.
All right. Work.
What do you mean? From Chinese boys.
Chicken wings?
Yeah, tell your boy there. He'll follow him. Richie, tell Richie. Okay. Jardo.
Let's go.
Come on.
engineers, train number one, SM train one, over.
Head into one.
Yeah, we're all closed and secure on train number one, out.
All closed up, okay, thanks, Steve.
Thank you. down, we'll put the safety latch on so nobody ends up back in the wall. And we'll catch the upper here.
Okay, ready to go. When the rails are broken, we're the smoothest engineers you've ever had.
There you go. All ready for a night night.
Go on up, see you, sister.
Go up, Jess, buddy.
Hey, that's a boy. Keep going.
I think this is too wiggly. Oh, my
goodness. That's a boy.
Don't take that off. Jamie, it might up. Fall.
Is it right there, buddy?
Is that fun up there, you guys?
Battery isn't very cool. Wiggly.
It's not very wiggly. It's sturdy.
right now. It's got nice clean air for Christmas cake.
One of the coldest days out here this year right now. Yeah, at least minus 40.
Yeah, this is only March.
Yeah, spring has sprung. Okay. Woo-hoo! Madam, if you have wet hair, it's going to be frozen in a minute.
Non, fais pas ça.
-40.
I believe it is. It's chilly.
Yeah, this is winter. This is Canada, Northern Ontario, winter. Cold, but we love it.
Minus 48 with the wind chill factor. Breezy, breezy. Weather is so cold out right now that the drips of our drains just come straight out onto the outside of the car and run right on the track for our gray water. And the water gets so cold coming out that the drains start freezing up solid. That's what we have happened right now, that the water drain has froze up solid on us. And they got no water coming out of our sinks that are frozen inside. Well, we have to get into Winnipeg in 6 more hours and they can probably take some hot water, or they could use some steam and they'll steam out the hole in the trap, and that'll give us the clear runaway for our drain again. We're suffering right now. The people have to use the gentleman's washroom just to use their washing hands and brushing their teeth, so we don't have our sink full of water and splashing water all inside our washrooms. It's at this type of weather, minus 40, 48, trains start freezing up with water drains like that. Surprising, no toilets have froze yet. We don't need any of those. But that's the weather. Welcome to Canada.
Watch your step, please, sir.
Might work. I'm gonna try one more quick one. Anthony, don't close the doors yet. Thank you.
here.
8 times 6.
It kills me. So,
there's time change coming too.
Now, Kate. Kate. Hello, Kate. And what's the name of the river that runs through Winnipeg? You know? And it joins, or it gets joined by the Assiniboine.
That's a
place called the Forks. And actually, if she was there, she should go.
My wife I met in South America. She agreed to marry me and come to Canada, and so we did our honeymoon 22 or 23 years ago on the Canadian. So we do this on a kind of regular basis, and we love it.
That's what we did for our honeymoon. We took the train from Calgary back to Toronto, and I couldn't believe it. That's what we're still doing with our kids now. Yeah.
It's a very decadent way of traveling. You just sit there and someone else can handle everything else. All I have to care about is getting fed.
It's fantastic.
Oh, it's
actually
beautiful.
It's the first time across. For me, especially in the train across Canada, it's the first time I've ever gone that far. I mean that far from back there.
And to get to see your own country, being such a vast country, what better way to see it than by train?
Well, they're more relaxed. It's more tranquil on the train. People are themselves. They don't have to be somebody else. So I just like meeting people.
There's a little sort of village community that forms. You get to meet people you'd never meet otherwise. You have dinner with them, breakfast with them, chat with them. It's unique.
Hey, look at the size of this one. It's got
this
three
one's longer,
domes.
Yeah, there's nobody in
there. 13, 18,
19
cars on this one, including the two engines.
Wow. People always ask me at work, how are you going to entertain yourself for 3 days on the train? And I always say that I never have a problem. I take books and I never read them. I'm constantly looking out and it's always different. So that's the way it is for us.
National shops over there, right?
That's right.
Transcontinental
shop, maintenance, locomotive repair.
Mm-hmm.
I'm getting off right here. They have like about 1,000 miles. I'm really close to another province. Where my dad wants to go next is in
there. There's a walking tower. Look at the guys on top of the tower too.
Where?
Right over here, the ice sculpture.
Oh yeah.
You'll catch another opening here right away.
Yeah, I got it.
Got him?
Red River. Cool, didn't it? Don't want to put your hand on that glass for too long.
Hit something a little bit.
Right.
Yeah.
Thank you, Robert.
All right, guys, take care. It's been very nice. Too bad I have to go home. I'd love to stay on with you, but this 40 below weather's just got to take me home.
Reporting for train number one will take place at approximately 5 p.m. Reporting at approximately 5 p.m. local time is 4:32.
Thank you. just the train travel. It's a special thing that a lot of people are rediscovering. That it's a fun way to travel. It's a fun way to meet people, and it's the best way to see a country. What we try and do is serve regional cuisine from across Canada. As we go, we'll feature foods that we would find as we travel across Canada.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, let's see, tonight, prime rib. That's probably our number one dish that we serve. It's known as a tradition with us, our prime rib.
All ready to go?
Yeah.
Thank you. Ça va?
I've got my vegetables. I've got some cauliflower and some zucchini tonight, and I've got those just in a warm-up. They're ready to go. I've got my prime rib all ready to go here. I've got some chicken ready to go. And as well as my steam table here, I've got some baked potatoes all done. I've got the wild rice pilaf. And I've also got made up a little curry, it's a vegetarian curry for occasionally get some vegetarian orders.
Ready?
Okay, ready to rock and roll.
Hey, hurry up and wait. Yeah, I'm just waiting for the orders to come in, and then there's a few last things to cook to order. We've got a steelhead trout tonight, that would be to order.
Got another one for him.
Wait. Chicken. Okay. We got a steelhead trout here tonight. A little coating with the pumpkin seed and herbs.
More soup,
crushed.
Three soups, I need a fish chowder, please.
Qu'est-ce que tu fais? Tu veux voir mes amis?
Oh. Yeah, I'm just gonna let these finish in the oven.
Table 12 would like a Chardonnay.
Pacific built the railway connecting Canada from east to west, and in 1882, one of those railway surveyors stumbled upon Lake Louise while he was doing some surveying work in the area, originally named it Emerald Lake, and a few years later it was christened Lake Louise after Princess Louise Caroline, Alberta. Well, the head of the Canadian Pacific Railway, William Cornelius Van Horn, 2 years before the development of the Chateau Lake Louise, built Canada's castle in the Rockies, our sister hotel, the Fairmont Banff Springs. And that was really part of an incredible vision to unite the political promise and the practical opportunities of the railway together with tourism, hotels, and the shipping line that he also managed. In 1899, Canadian Pacific Railway hired a group of Swiss guides to come over and teach people to climb in the mountains safely. And that was really instrumental in building not only what this place would look like in terms of what you could do, but what this place would look like in terms of having a style and an architecture and a finish and an ambiance. Very much people remark that if you go through the rooms of our hotel, there are many details that are reminiscent of chalets in Switzerland. And that pays homage to our Swiss guides. The magic plan was to recreate the Grand Tour in Europe, in North America, bringing people from the cities of the East to the open wilderness of the West. This destination represented the Grand Tour through the Rockies, that sort of idea of an idyllic holiday where you would quite literally spend your entire holiday going from place to place, leaving a city like New York or Toronto and going west.
Jasper?
Oh no, not yet.
Thank you.
All set? Your mic, Dad?
Yep, looks pretty good.
Stretch.
Your pocket, man.
It's pretty bad when it's snowy like this, isn't it?
Yeah, oh yeah. It's pretty encrusted, especially the engines. When we have to separate the engine, that's where it's a real nightmare. There.
But you're used to it, I imagine.
Well, you've been doing it a long time. So, it's not a preferable way to do it. We like the summer. I live in Kamloops. I used to live here in Jasper, but I live in Kamloops now, and much like the winter there than here. Even though I still ski, every day I get a chance, it's just as soon... have it nice where I work and live. Right.
Well, Jasper Park Lodge began as a wilderness tank camp in 1915. It was, you know, pristine wilderness. It was absolutely unchartered. The location was absolutely ideal. And a tourist agent from the Grand Trunk Pacific Railway saw the potential of this area being established. And basically what he did was he hooked up with a gentleman, Robert Kenneth, from the Edmonton Tent and Mattress Company. And they also married themselves with a pair of outfitters from the area, Fred and Jack Brewster. They were brothers. They collaborated together and built 10 tent camps along the shores of Lac Beauvert. There was a dining pavilion, there was a dance pavilion. Of course, during the years, you know, from 1915 to 1921, the area increased with, you know, the types of bungalows that they had in the area. But basically, it was a pristine wilderness tent camp. It was VIP service, there was linen, there was silver, you know, people played bridge. I mean, it catered to the wealthy American who wanted to come out into the area and, you know, literally trek and do mountaineering in this uncharted territory. And then come 1921, the hotel department of the Canadian National Railway came on board and they purchased the Wilderness Tent Camp. And in 1922, that's when Jasper Park Lodge became Jasper Park Lodge. And then at that time, they started to build some log bungalows. You started to see some of the picturesque paths of the village being carved onto the property. It started to become a resort. Well, the first main lodge was built. It took hundreds of men to build it. It only took about 9 months to build it. And it was touted, once it was erected, as the largest single-story log structure in the world. It was absolutely immense. 1946, The Emperor Waltz was filmed here with Bing Crosby, who was an avid golfer himself, as well as a fisherman. So when there was downtime for him off of the set, he was out on the course. And he was actually quite a local favorite, simply because of his relaxed manner. He was very friendly with the locals. He was actually known to do these impromptu, you know, little musical sets. He was actually in our dining room on the property, and this little boy saw him walking by, and he's, you know, whispered to his mom, "Geez, I wish he would sing." And he got up and did a 20-minute impromptu set in the dining room. You know, having Marilyn Monroe out here, although she never did stay at the lodge, the movie that she was working on was filmed in the area, and, you know, she did come on the property. They did host some of their sort of, you know, production parties and things like that in Point Cabin and Outlook Cabin. When she was dating, and I don't know if she was married to Joe DiMaggio at the time, but they were seeing each other. He flew his helicopter into the park and came out to visit her at the time that she was filming A River of No Return. So in the early 1950s, we were kind of touted as the Hollywood of the North. I think it's a bit of a Canadian tradition. I mean, we can appreciate four true seasons up in Canada, but when winter comes, we are in the pristine wilderness of a national park.
Stopped in 10 minutes. Thank you. Tucson's aren't too bad.
Time to go?
Yep.
Hold on.
Secured in section B.
All cars are secured in B section, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, you just want to see the sky?
meat?
Oh, no.